Hey guys, SuperHorrorBro Mike here, and welcome to Happy's Humble Burger Barn. Now, some of you are probably going to know what this game is, and other people are going to be like, wait, didn't you just play this game? Well, that was actually called Happy's Humble Burger Farm. This is called Happy's Humble Burger Barn, and this is actually the game that was made by the same development team about a year earlier, and it's actually the prequel to Happy's Humble Burger Farm. So as I'm hoping to put together a story explained video for that at some point, I wanted to get the backstory from this game because it'll help contextualize the events in Happy's Humble Burger Farm. It's cute, it's really hard to keep up with both these titles. We're going to see where the game and its story started off, so sit back, relax, and let's dive into this game and witness the origins of Happy's Humble Burger Farm. And look, we're in a car. Drive to work and park on the side. Oh, this is cool, so we actually get to drive in this game. Look at this. Got that nice synthwave soundtrack. So I wonder if this takes place in the same sort of virtual reality simulation that Happy's Humble Burger Farm took place in on the island. Ooh, what's that? Is that a dead cow in front of us? I think it might be. Can I see it? Not really. I think we've just actually rolled over that cow as well, but oh well, it was already dead. It's fine. It's not gonna do any more harm to it, is it? Let's keep going. Look, there's the city in the distance. I think that's Elysian City that we live in the first game. And here we go, guys. Yeah, this is Happy's Humble Burger Barn. This is actually the original site that we find in ruins underneath, of course, Happy's Humble Burger Farm, which was the second restaurant they built in the second simulation that we experience in the game we just played. So this is really cool. I'm guessing we're gonna find out a little bit more about Paragon and Obscura as we play through this. And like a glove, there we go. Time to get out and start the shift, I guess. So here we go, we're out the car now and it says use left mouse to interact, okay? I'm actually gonna go and have a look at the front of this store first because this is of course the original site that was built over in the second game. We actually find the ruins of this place in Happy's Humble Burger Farm. And you can see, of course, in the background there, we have Elysian City or New Elysian City, which is the city we live in the game we just played. Follow instructions displayed top right. Okay, grab your time card and clock in. So where are we clocking in? Here, I guess? Yeah. Nice. Interact with the environment. There we go. Easy. We've turned the lights on. So this is Happy's Humble Burger Farm. Look at that. A nice patty. And there's the characters. Happy, Petey, and I think Charlie are the names of those characters. Yeah, the Fantastic Fowl Burger, Poppin' Pork Burger, and of course the Happy Deluxe Burger. It's all familiar. Read all of the instructions. Okay, how to make a Happy's Deluxe. Grab a frozen patty from the freezer and throw it on the grill. Place the bun, lettuce, tomato, onion, and pickles onto the assembly board. Place the cooked patty on the assembly board. Watch as the burger magically constructs itself. Serve it to the customer with a big, happy, humble smile. So it's the same pretty much as what we did in the first game. Well, I keep calling it the first game. Of course, it was the second game technically. Next it says turn on the open sign, so let's go and do that. Oh yeah, and look, this is actually the same layout. We actually visited this place towards the end of Happy's Humble Burger Farm. So yeah, it's exactly the same, because this is the cow that I said was the low graphic settings version of Happy. We actually can see that this is taken from this original game, which is really cool. So let's turn on the open sign. And I guess people are going to start coming in, so we want to start prepping burgers for people. Manage customers as they come in. Chilled patties. We want to get one of these. Throw that on here. That's cooking. Okay, what do you want? Wow, that's kind of creepy. They want two shakes. Okay, easy enough. So there we go, and then we throw it at him there. One. And then get the next one and throw it at him there. Two. Okay, so that's how we do it. Sorry, I got a bit confused, guys, because it's a bit different than Happy's Humble Burger Farm in how it plays. And so I was getting a little bit confused there. But I think we're getting the hang of it now. It's a bit easier as well, because we don't actually have to cook the fries. They're already ready for us. So there's no more people here yet. So we're just waiting for people to come in. Oh, we've got the next customer coming in now. another creepy looking specimen if I ever saw one. Kind of looks a bit like an android. I thought he was going to come in then and try and fight us. Okay, he wants Happy Stelux fries. Okay. Here's some fries, my man. Enjoy. Which is quite easy so far. I'm liking the difficulty level. It's manageable for me. Oh, they want a Happy's Deluxe as well. Okay, we can do that. So for a Happy's Deluxe, we need to get one of each of these. Okay, is that right? Yeah, there we go. It's a bit strange. I didn't know if it was working because it didn't look like it was actually attaching, but it did attach eventually. There we go. So we got him served next. This game really looks like an old PS1 game as well. It's got that kind of PS1 look to it, which is kind of cool. We've got another guy coming in here. Another person strolling up. What would you like? Happy's Deluxe and Salmon Nuggets. Nice, okay. Can do. First of all, we'll get you the Salmon Nuggets. Here you go. And now I'll get you another burger from here. Here we go. Throw that on there. And just get one of these. One of these. One of these. One of these. And hopefully this will cook. There we go, nice. And that's another patty ready. Take out all of the trash from the kitchen. Right, so where's the trash? Oh, it's here. So we'll take this out, and I think we actually parked near the dumpster. Yeah, here we go. Just throw it in there. Get the next one. Unlike Happy Tumble Burger Farm, you can't actually hold more than one item at a time. So it makes all these processes far slower. And free. Nice. Investigate the noise. What noise? Where did that come from? I kind of heard something, but... well, it's locked. Looks like we have to go around the front. Man, I actually can hear a noise now. That's kind of creepy. Have I not got a flashlight? What the heck is that? Happy? Is that you? Man, I want the light to be on. Can I not turn the light on? Is that a floating hamburger? This is very strange. Alright, I'm going into the kitchen. Let's put the lights back on. This is kind of freaking me out a little bit. Okay, the light is on. What? Where's the noise coming from? Look, somebody's blocked us from coming in. That's why we couldn't get back in. There you go. Continue to manage customers. That was weird. Okay. So we just wait for the next customer to come then. Here we go. We've got another one. Strolling in. Taking his sweet time. Come on, my man. What would you like? Take the money. Put it in there. He wants fries. That's easy enough. Boom. Wow, he was really easy to serve. He just wanted fries. Sometimes you just want fries, you know? It's no more complex than that. I feel like I need a challenge. Are you gonna give me a bigger order? Like, give me salmon nuggets, a shake, a soft drink, a burger, you know, two lots of fries or something. Soft drink, salmon nuggets, fries. All right, that's a little bit more of a challenge. Here we go, that's soft drink first. Salmon nuggets. Here you go. And some fries. There we are. You're welcome, have a good day. Now we just wait again. It's just kind of the monotony of the shift, isn't it? The monotony of a work day. I'm just waiting for one of these guys to attack me or something. Fries. Is that it? You just want fries. Fair enough. It's easy enough to me to source out. Here we go then. Oh, wow. Check the drive-thru speaker outside. Okay. Oh, outside. We gotta go outside. Of course we gotta go outside. Hello, anyone there? Oh, okay. Happy's there. Hello, Happy. Call your boss on the office phone. Yeah, let's get away from that. Oh, someone's blocked us in again. Or locked us out, I should say. I haven't locked us in, have they? Screw this. I'm turning the lights on. For some reason, I feel a lot safer when the lights are on. I'm just running. I hate that noise. Man, that noise is horrible. Right, phone. Listen for the instructions. Someone pick up.
Yeah, hello?
Hello?
Whoa, what? Who put the what in the cow? The cow's in the middle of the drive-thru.
Yes, that's correct.
Is this a fucking joke?
No, it's not a joke.
I don't know. What the fuck do you mean it walked over there?
I'm telling you, it walked over there, man.
Alright, I'll get someone out there to move it. Just stay put.
I appreciate it. Boss man. Continue to manage customers. Okay, we gotta keep going. It seems like every time we serve like 3 or 4 customers, something creepy happens. So I'm guessing we just keep serving these customers and see what the next event will be. Money? Thank you. A Happy's Deluxe. Ooh, exciting. Get to do a bit more this time. Let's grab a patty. Throw it down to cook. Burger bun. Down there. Gherkin. Tomato. Bit of onion. And of course, don't forget the lettuce. There we go. Now we just wait for this to cook. There we go. Assemble. Burgers assemble. And here you go. Enjoy. Have a happy day. Just you and me now, Happy Junior. We've got a drive-through, but it's offline. Kind of glad. I remember the drive-through in Happy's humble burger farm was like super hard to manage. I couldn't keep up with it. Right, another guy. He says, I'll have a shake, please. Okay. 2 shakes. And salmon nuggets. Can do. 1 shake. 2 shake. Salmon nuggets. Here we are. Oh. Wow. What the heck? Look at all those people outside looking at me. That's horrible. Go outside? What the heck? I don't want to go outside. Look at them, they're just naked now. Man, that is creepy. That's horrible. Look at his head just twisting. It's like The Exorcist or something. Alright, let's go outside. My god, that is horrible. What is happening? They're huge. We've got a full moon outside. Okay, the head. Hello, sir. Whoa, okay. What was that? I'm running. Oh, yeah, look, it's a simulation. The story continues. This, wait a second. Is this when the nuke first went off on the island? I think it is. Let's go. Restricted area. Yeah, we literally go through here, and this is where the security guard stops us in Happy's Humble Burger Farm. This is really cool. So it's kind of like we're actually seeing what happened from someone else's perspective on that same day, 5 years ago when the nuke went off. I haven't got a flashlight though. We've got another one of these things. Yeah, all the test subjects. Well, these are actually the synthetics, aren't they? The little kind of robot people that were being made. Why Obscura? Oh, it's too dark. I don't like this. This is really creepy. Man, I love the concept of how they continued it in the actual game. And look, we've got a note here. What is this? Simulation scenarios. The wage slave. Location, Happy's Humble Burger Barn. Premise, low-wage fast food worker, living paycheck to paycheck, methods, audio and visual brain entertainment, trauma-based climax, light drugging, So that's what we went through, the wage slave scenario in the first game, and this is from Paragon, as you can see at the top, genetic technology, simulation scenarios, a brief rundown of current and running simulations. Another one is the lifesaver. Location of that is the Maple Overlook Hospital. Premise, nurse's aide, janitor. Methods, continual trauma, medium drugging. And then the graveyard shift. Legacy Lawn Burial Grounds. Premise, gravedigger. Visual brain entertainment. Theatrical trauma, heavy drugging. The Thrill Seeker. Location, Seven Banners Theme Park. Premise, ride operator. Forced trauma, peripheral trauma. So there we go, guys. That actually gives us more information about the different kinds of test subjects and what happened to them. Look, we're inside Paragon now by the look of it. We've got a big shiny statue of a naked woman there. The guy obviously liked his women. He ran this place. There's another note over here as well. What does this say? Northbury Grove Massacre. Status on the Rock for warehouse teenagers who came in direct contact with a butcher of Northbury Grove. Grace Bailey, status alive, was kidnapped from a Rock Warehouse Music Festival campgrounds, managed to escape his lair, only to encounter him again 1 year later and survive. Then we have Connor Ledune, status alive, encountered the butcher at Alcanar Factory and managed to escape. He also recorded footage of his encounter. NGPD has possession of the tapes. Crystal Quint, status deceased, encountered the butcher at the Rock the Warehouse Music Festival grounds. She did not survive. And then we have Trevor Quint, status deceased, managed to escape the killer at the King's Comfort Motel. That's the motel we were in Happy's Humble Burger Farm. However, a year later he was killed at Northbury Grove Estate. Interesting. Okay, let's go. And look, there's that Dr. Grimm character. There he is. Let's have a read of this then. So, Paragon Genetic Technology, the Cheese Maze Initiative. In this series of experiments, we will attempt to influence or control the minds of our test subjects through themed auditory and visual cues. These cues will be intensified to a dramatic conclusion, at which time the subject should theoretically be under our control whenever they are subjected to a trigger. Test subjects who manage to break their conditioning tend to panic into a fight or flight response. We observed this behavior in only 0.5% of our test subjects. Of that 0.5, a rare 1 out of 100 shut down completely. An even rarer 1 out of 500 got violent. They were disposed of accordingly. Each test subject is placed in a customized scenario and subjected to several cycles of therapy and programming. The therapy and programming normalizes the scenario and embeds deep mental triggers. When a subject is released back into the wild, they can now be triggered into a subservient state. The goal of this experiment is to discover a means of indefinite hypnotic control and or influence over desired subjects. A constant state of hypnosis is not a desirable outcome. A so-called sleeper state of hypnosis that can be activated via verbal, audio, or visual cues is ideal. Triggers can include a frequency emitted through radios and cellular devices, or images broadcast on television and computer screens. Once subjects have been triggered, theoretically, handlers can then assume control of and direct the subjects, herding the sheep, as Dr. Grimm himself put it. So this is how they controlled everyone, the Cheese Maze Initiative. That's interesting. And that's obviously Dr. Grimm. So let's keep going and see what happens next. See what we can discover. It's like a tree in here. It's very strange. Anything else that we can read? Any notes? Don't think so. So we got to go through here next. Oh, I can hear something in the vents. What's this? Genetic Technology Wing 13. In the event of an emergency, follow the evacuation protocol. The entire facility has been marked with path indicators on the floor as depicted below. Okay, so that's conference hall lobby. Remain calm and leave in an orderly fashion. All right, let's go. Wait, what's this? Can I go in here? No. All right, let's just keep going forward then. I don't think we can head into any of these doors. It's pretty linear right now. What about through here? Yes. Ooh, there's a dead person and loads of notes on the floor. That looks like it's one of the scientists, and he's got a tape. Can we play this? There we go. Right, let's check this out.
If you're watching this, I hope you made it out. I know I won't, but I hope this tape will. I've lived a long and fortuitous life, and for many years, I was shielded from the horrors of humanity and the brutality of nature. But upon taking a job from Dr. Zane Grimm, I've seen things I can't explain. Horrors that have haunted my dreams. Paragon has made massive strides in technology. We pushed humanity forward centuries. But I'm afraid we're about to send it back to the Stone Age. At first, we were just trying to help the community. Grimm became determined to save it, to play God. That was when our research became unethical at best and diabolical at worst. The facility is committing crimes against humanity, and I can no longer stand idly by and let this happen. Surely we are now paying the consequences for our hubris, toying with human life, altering the consciousness of innocent people in sick experiments, forged of indoctrination and psychological slavery. I can't live with myself any longer. But before I shed this existence for the next, I must blow the whistle on the inhumane and cruel practices happening at this and all other Outcast Island research facilities. I've shipped this video and massive data packages to every media outlet I could find, from the Sabbath Broadcasting Company to Maverick Cooper. And I will expose the vile underbelly of Paragon. Dr. Grimm was once a good man, but he has lost his mind. Surely, I've lost mine as well. We cannot cure death. We cannot even cure our own avarice and vanity. And we surely cannot stop what's coming.
So that's really interesting. So that is the whistleblower who ends up leading our character to the art. Wait, so what's that? Oh my god! Oh, that was Happy. That was like the demonic version of Happy. And there you go, Happy's Humble Burger Farm is, of course, the game we just played. So that's really interesting, guys. That actually sets up everything. I wish I'd played that before I'd played the sequel. I didn't actually realize that Happy's Humble Burger Farm was the sequel. But that guy at the end was the whistleblower that's basically referenced by our journalist character. I think he's called like Randy or something. I can't remember his name, or Randall. He basically kind of mentions at some point that he's been working with a whistleblower who sort of invited him to this island to research into Paragon's dark human experimentation and stuff, but he ends up falling under this human experimentation, being subjected to it and getting trapped in the simulation himself, of course. But I will try and make a story explain video going through all this stuff, guys. It was really cool to finally play this though, and I hope you enjoyed my little playthrough. Hopefully it's cleared up some of the questions you might have had after watching my playthrough of the other game, Happy's Humble Burger Farm. With that said, thanks for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, remember to leave a like, comment down below, and of course subscribe for more videos just like this one. If you want to check out this game, it's linked in the description below. And of course, Happy's Humble Burger Farm is on Steam now, so I'll link that as well. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next video.